In lesson 7, we learned that the Y in mitochondrial chromosomes can be used to trace both the paternal and maternal lines.
But let's do a quick recap to learn why the Y can trace the paternal side and the mitochondria can trace the maternal side.
All right, so let's set up a little scenario here. Let's imagine that I have biological children.
Congratulations.
Thank you. And I pass down my X chromosome. What sex will the child be?
Be a female, because the mother has two X's, so she can only pass down the X. And you passed out an X, and so you have a child with two X's, baby girl.
Exactly. Now, what happens if I pass down my Y chromosome?
Well, the mother, again, only passes down the X, and you gave a Y, and so an XY equals a baby boy, so you'd have a male child.
Exactly, and we can use this Y chromosome to trace back father to father to father, and that's how we trace the paternal line.
And the mitochondria are only passed down by the mother, so they trace your maternal line.
Precisely. This means that if you're a male, you can actually submit a DNA sample, and you'll get information about your maternal and paternal lines because you have both mitochondria and a Y chromosome. But if you're a female, you only have mitochondria, so you can't actually get your paternal information just from your own DNA sample. You're going to have to use someone else in your family. I want you to tell me, which of the following relatives would you not want to use if you're a female and you want to get information about your paternal lineage?